Hi, today I'm in the workshop instead of the lab, and I'm going to adjust the blades on my planer thicknesser. It's a Jet JPT-260, for those interested. Now, I think in the US, this is called a jointer planer. The set of blades that are fitted at the moment, they've done a lot of hard work. They've started to tear on difficult cross grain. So I've honed them in place for the moment until I replace them, and I'll have them properly sharpened then. The reason I'm making do is that I've got loads of reclaimed oak to tidy up, and I'm a bit worried about finding some nasty bits of embedded metal and things like that, so I don't want to risk a new set of blades. But fitting a new set is really the same process. It's all about adjusting these blades so they are perfectly flat, identical to each other. Now, taking even a tiny amount off these blades has meant they're now just below the level of the outfeed table. As a result, it doesn't really plane correctly. They should be just a whisper above and just catching on this piece of aluminium as it turns. Anyway, of course they must also be exactly level with the table, and every blade, those three on this block, must protrude exactly the same amount. Let's take a quick close-up look at the important parts. So of course we've got the blade. The blade is held in place with a clamp, so that's the darker bit of metal just behind it, and there are five square-headed bolts in that bar. Now, because the bar is in a groove, then when you unscrew those bolts, it actually forces that clamp tightly against the blade and locks it in place. The blade itself sits on top of a pair of hex-headed screws that are kind of quite recessed in, about an inch down. And as you raise and lower these, it causes the blade to slide further in or out. And that really just leaves the question, well, how far out, and how do you get it identical at both ends of all three blades? The easiest way is to use some sort of indicator block. This aluminium one was provided by the manufacturer, but you can use a bit of aluminium or wood. Just make sure it's very flat and smooth. The little slot in the bottom is 4 millimeters wide, it's actually 4.1, or you can just make two lines on your makeshift block about that width apart. So in use, you rotate the blade so that it's before its cutting position, then you align the first line or the side of the slot with the table edge. Then you move the blade forward very, very slowly. The blade will just catch the block enough to move it forward, and it should hopefully move it forward exactly that 4 millimeters. If it's more than 4 millimeters, your blade's sticking out too much. If it's less, then it's not sticking out enough. So when every part of the blade moves that block the same amount, you've got it right. So time to look at the process in full. Now, I've already done two blades, so this is the last one. And the first job is actually just to check to see where the blades are set, whether they're high, low, or what. In this case, it's below the level of the table. So if you're fitting a new blade, this is where you actually want to start. Push those screws in a little bit so the blade starts too low, because it's a lot easier to work the blade outwards and keep measuring it till you get it right. Now, the first thing to do, of course, loosen those five clamping bolts. I loosen them just enough so they're not rattling loose, but barely gripping the blade. So I actually loosen them off quite a lot, then I just edge it up till I just feel it kind of snugging up, just a tiny bit. You want that blade to move up and down easily, but not be rattling and loose. Now, adjust the height adjusters until you just feel them touch the underside of the blade. So you want to know that you're actually adjusting the blade, not just kind of spinning a nut underneath. And just a whisper more until both ends of the blade just start kissing or scuffing the underside of the block, and you'll probably be able to actually hear that. You won't really see the block move necessarily, but you might just hear them scuffing it. Right, finally, then you move them a shade. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, take up the slack on the key, you'll feel it, and just move it a degree or so more. That's all, nothing more than that. I just take up the slack, then I just apply enough pressure to feel it start to move. The trick here is to do it little and often. If you overshoot, then you have to ease the screw back a bit and then tap the blade down with a wooden block and then just repeat all over again. You have to get this right. There can't be any compromise. If you don't get these blades exactly the same as each other, or you get them sloping slightly, then you'll get a horrible result when you actually start planing. Now, when you've got it right, then you tidle the middle retaining bolt and work outwards towards the edge of the bolt. Now, you're only lightly tightening, not really tight. You just want to hold that blade in position, and then you recheck it, and then you're going to tighten them again a bit more. Still not to full tightness. Check it again, and then this time fully tighten it. But you're always working kind of from the center towards the outside. You do not want to apply any turning tension or anything onto that blade. It must stay in position. once you've done all three blades, or all four blades, or however many on your machine, then recheck them all a last time, make any last corrections, and then it's time to try it out. Ideally you want a widish bit of timber, but I like to start with something a bit easier and try various positions across the blade. I'm just using a bit of scrap oak, and I've set a 1mm cut, so this is fairly aggressive. And I think the actual finish is coming out really good, so I'm confident I can move on now with the real work. A couple of safety points. One is that throughout this I had the actual power disconnected completely. Do not want those blades to spin by accident. And also I took the guard off so that I could get good access. You kind of have to do that, really. I didn't have to take it apart any more than that. Of course, before you run it again, you do want to fit the guard. I didn't do that because I needed you to be able to see what was going on the video. But of course, at the end, always refit the guard. And there we go. Anyway, that's it. I hope it was informative. Don't forget to subscribe, to like the video, comment, share it with your friends, and all that sort of thing. Anyway, bye for now.